Welcome back, everyone. We just saw a full day of the Hearthstone World Championships, and the players put up a great fight. Four will move on to the semifinals tomorrow, but right now, we have the finals of our Challenge Zone Special Edition, BlizzCon Edition. And I do hope you guys stick around and cheer for these next two players. You're gonna love the first one. It's Amaz. And his opponent, taking out Froden, we have Savitz. All right, guys, join me in the center of this stage here. Both of you have come a long way, one match to qualify for this final. And I know it's a big deal to you, so please tell me, Amaz, what would winning this Challenge Stone mean to you?
Well, first of all, I haven't joined any Challenge Stones yet, so winning this would mean I have 100% win rate, which is pretty sweet. But Savitz is gonna be a tough opponent. I do not want to mind games a Doomsayer at all.
Very specific call out there, Amaz. Well, Savitz, you are an experienced Challenge Stone player, but what would it mean to you to win this Challenge Stone?
Oh, it would mean a lot to me to win on this stage here today. The previous Challenge Stone that I played in didn't go so well, so also because of that, I would really want to win now.
Well, do you think it's any accident that the two players who made it to the Challenge Stone Finals are the two professional players in the bracket?
Well, maybe.
Solid answer. Thanks, Savitz. All right, guys, I'm going to give you one opportunity to address the fans here because I know you both have huge live streaming audiences. I know so many people turned out to watch you two in particular play each other. So, Amaz, you go first. What do you want to say to the people?
Well, to all the Hearthstone viewers watching right now, you probably watched the whole day, so, you know, good job. And, you know, today's going to be awesome. I'm going to beat Savitz here, and then we're wrapping up the day, and then tomorrow we're going to crown a world champion.
All right, sounds like a busy weekend, and I'm pretty excited to get started. Savitz, tell us, what do you want to say to the people?
Well, I hope the Major Dome works out. I hope you're rooting for me.
All right, we'll see who's rooting for who and who takes the win. Gentlemen, if you would please shake hands and get on into the booth. I'm going to hand it back to our casters to recap the challenge rules and the decks that these two created. So Crip, Reynad, and Hype, take it away.
Thank you, Rachel, and welcome to the Challenge Stone Final. Here we have Reynad and Hyped with me once again. Just to quickly recap what's going on here, Challenge Stone, we tried to test the deck building capabilities of our participants by giving them a timed challenge to build decks, and they then have to use to win tournament. And in this particular challenge, the players are given 25 minutes to make three decks that each had to include 10 World of Warcraft raid bosses. You know, these are actually pretty big cards in general. There's a few small cards like the Valkyries and a few others that kind of made a bit of an impact. Notably, Fugin and Stalag made a big impact in some of today's games. There was still quite a lot of play when it came to the bigger minions, because with 10 in every deck, you have to include some of them. So, you know, we have Amaz and Savitz here in our final. Let's have a look at the ones that they included in each of their decks. This is Amaz's list here. Out of the 19, he gets pretty good coverage. Looks like he's missing 7, 12. Not too much variety, but certainly more than his first opponent, who we crushed the Dragon Master Kibler, who had exactly the same 10 in all three of his decks.
Yeah, I think these might be the only two players that played Gormok in their decks, actually. But yeah, Savitz has a lot of similar minions. He's got the Fugin Stalag combo. He's got his, like, the Aedas Fjord Lightbane combo. This has probably been the most common raid bosses that we've seen so far. Mm-hmm.
Well, I think out of all the raid bosses, the only two that were not picked is Myxna, which is somewhat of a surprise, and the other is Gruul. Is that surprising?
Not at all.
What is surprising is Amaz had that Ice Howl. Does he have some sort of special synergy with that? Is he going to silence it, or is he just going to run it into stuff?
Well, it's removal that might stay another turn, remove something else, I think.
Yeah, you can't play big game hunter, right? I mean, yeah. Some classes want the extra big removal spell, I suppose. If you're gonna play something expensive, might as well help you catch up on board.
All right, well, the players are ready on stage. Let's head down there for game number one. Any predictions for the opening classes? Priest and Paladin have fared the best so far in the tournament.
Yeah, we've seen people open Priest twice at least, right?
Three times, I think.
Okay.
If I had to guess, I would say that Savitz will not play the Mage deck. I may have lied.
And the Mage deck against the Paladin.
He's here to prove a point, you know?
I actually think this is a good matchup for the Mage. As strong as Paladin is, the way that Amaz built the Paladin deck, it's very strong in creature combat because he has an overwhelming amount of buffs, but it's very weak if he constantly gets his creatures removed, which is basically the point of Savitz's deck.
Right, I mean, it's pretty much control mage, a lot of the same removal that we see in the ranked lists of mage control decks. Double Doomsayer, too. The only person playing that card, I think.
Freeze Mage so far.
Yeah.
Savitz has opted for a more Freeze Mage type of deck. I believe we've seen Ice Block, Ice Barrier, and Duplicate from the secret list.
How important is Doomsayer in the Paladin matchup?
It's very good. There's like no counter. There's maybe one Owl, and there's Equality Swing with your Lights Justice, maybe. But basically, Amaz's whole board is going to be full of Divine Shields, which just aren't going to be completely useless against Doomsayer.
All right, well, we see the creature problem there. Amaz has a lot of complementary cards for creatures, but no actual creatures to play yet.
Yeah, definitely one of the awkward hands that you can get when you play that many kind of reactive cards, things like Equality, Humility, the buffs. I mean, if you don't get that early board lead, it's really tough to get full value out of your cards that you have. Argent Protector, I mean, right now, if this minion were to die, it's really just, you have to play a Sylvanas on an empty board, and the rest of the hand, it really just doesn't do much until you actually stick a minion.
Now, one thing we haven't seen, I believe, is Fireball from Savitz. He has the big minions, he's got the Polymorphs, he's got the Freezes, but no Fireball means he can't really take advantage of the fact that Amaz has Sylvanas in at least two of his three decks. Because often, if you can kill Sylvanas and play a Doomsayer on empty board, you just get a very easy clear.
Oh, absolutely, yeah. Ironically, we've seen Savitz lose to Fireball with this deck, off of Nefarian, though, so.
Well, that might happen again, as I believe Amaz is running Nefarian almost every single deck.
So Amaz does get to stick his minions. One of the advantages of playing against a slow deck like this mage is that you have a lot of time to just develop stuff. Eventually, you'll draw stuff. But the thing is, Savitz is all right with taking some damage. His plan isn't to deal with every minion one by one as it comes out. His plan is just buy some time, get a Doomsayer to trigger, and then follow up with one large minion to take initiative on the board.
Now, if you play a Doomsayer here, you have to think that the only way you're losing it is to Equality, and then you have to wonder if maybe that's worth it.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, if you were to Equality there, the thing about Doomsayer dying to Equality in general is that it doesn't just Equality your minion, it Equalities their minions, and
that's
then
right. Your
hero power deals with everything left on board pretty easily. So you're usually not too worried about it getting Equality. So I would have liked to see a Doomsayer that turn, but what Savitz is thinking here is if I wait one more turn to Doomsayer, then I'll be able to follow up with Nyxia instead of just this 5-mana card in my hand. He's not just trying to get the best value out of his Doomsayer as far as how much stuff he kills. He's trying to get it to blow up at the right time so that he can follow up with the best threat. On an empty board, to be honest, as rarely as we see the card, there are a few minions in the game better than Nyxia.
Yeah, Nyxia, I've actually played it a few times in decks where I really struggle to find enough dragons, and I feel it doesn't underperform. Yeah. I'm not really blown away by the card, but I think there are really very few big minions in general Hearthstone play that blow you away that cost 9 mana.
Yeah. Most of them have very unique effect, things like Luxtraza or Ysera that wins over several turns, but Nyxia kills them pretty quickly.
And actually, Amaz chose not to Equality.
Oh, Savitz is going to go for the rag instead of the coin Nyxia. He's thinking about it. All right.
I mean, they bring the duplicate on the rag over a well, for example.
Right,
yeah. Yeah, the duplicate really does influence. Very, very good call there, Hyped.
Yeah, makes a ton of sense. So we've seen, I think, all three secrets from Savitz's deck so far, and I think those were Duplicate, Ice Barrier, Ice Block. So The plan is definitely slow the game down, copy my big animals, and then play them again. which is a pretty fun type of control deck. Works a lot in ranked, honestly. I know Hype, you have a lot of experience playing the more non-traditional mage decks like this. How do you feel about Savit's deck? Do you feel like this is one of the stronger ones in the tournament, or would you prefer to see something more standard like the Priest?
Well, the playing a big mage like this is all about the swing turns with Doomsayers, for example, and we've seen a lack of Doomsayer answers from our opponents, and Savit's got a perfect one out there, lay down the big minion, has the duplicate in play. I think it's going to work out for him. Even the Polymorph for the Sylvanas.
Absolutely. It's definitely been a slow start from the Paladin as well. That Polymorph just... Man, it's so tough to get a clean answer on Ragnaros. You usually need a two-card answer.
Stalag, if he holds Stalag, he can maybe get an extra Thaddeus, I'm thinking. Right? Because one Stalag had already died this turn. So if he can kill his opponent's Fugin, deal with a Thaddeus, or if he draws Fugin and then plays the Stalag.
Yeah, I think that's definitely a possibility. I think the bigger reason he's just hero powering here is just to increase the odds of Ragnaros hitting face. Mm-hmm. Nefarian, big pickup though for Amaz. You really need some good cards off this.
What can you get here? Oh, I can't.
Okay. Well, you can get some burn, Crip.
Wow, that is a lot of burn.
Yeah. All right, so Amaz is now looking at two true silver champions. He's sitting on
enough
24 damage.
Yeah.
Which is a very big number.
It is a very big number, but I believe Savitz has Ice Block up. I believe he played it earlier in the game.
He does. And we'll see if Savitz is playing something like Alexstrasza or like Healbot, something to really like pull his life total back up after that Ice Block is procced. But I mean, if he's not, we could easily see a just like no recovery, basically, from the Mage control deck. Mm-hmm. Playing a deck like this requires a lot of very specific cards that are useful in specific situations. So you don't just need a bunch of removal and finishers and 10 raid bosses, but you need to fit in things like Frost Nova, you need to fit in things like Heals, Secrets, Mad Scientist. So, for example, if just because of a lack of deck space, Savitz decided not to include any healing, that burn plan will work out, even if Ice Block does buy him one extra turn.
Yeah, that is in fact how he lost one of his prior games. There is no heal. It seems like a lot of these control mages, and especially the freeze mage, have a very well-balanced draw system and curve system. You know, they're slow decks, but they're just slow enough to where you can actually cycle through your cards and never overdraw none of that.
Absolutely. You can see Savitz, two turns in a row now, has decided not to play one of the sisters, and the reason he's doing that is out of fear of an equality turn. This turn, I might have liked to see one come down, because now Amaz has the option to kill off both of Savitz's minions. Savitz isn't too worried about that. He understands the duplicate. I think that's most of the reason he's not playing the 3-4. It's not just the equality combo. Mm-hmm. But it's definitely interesting like how much tempo has been lost just to make this duplicate work out.
Well, Amaz can trigger the Ice Block here.
Oh, I think he's going to go for it.
Okay, a little bit different than just a Pyroblast, and this will allow him to peacekeep the Stalag, I believe, which most likely prevents him from dying.
Yeah, putting Savitz to 2 life, also very relevant in case Amaz ends up drawing a Consecration. That's going to be just another card that can threaten lethal.
Yeah, right now Savitz might be looking to get like a freeze or something, but you know, even that's not going to work just because of the Pyroblast. Oh, can he do any manipulation with a Mad Scientist? I don't believe so.
No, there's no way to kill his own Scientist off. And I mean, this might just be game, right? I mean, this is what we were worried about. No healing, and all of a sudden, you just get hit with a weapon again. Or in this case, a Pyroblast for style points.
I wonder.
Well, on Savitz's side of the board, he has to assume his opponent has absolutely nothing. And in that very optimistic case, maybe Ragnaros can work some magic with face hits. But we know it's over. Savitz will end up dropping this one, and it might be a little bit of a climb, though not quite as much as it was in our opening rounds. Our opening rounds were best of three. In this final, they'll have to win with every single deck, which also changes up the game a little bit.
I mean, that's the beauty of of Challenge Stone, though. I mean, how often do you see a Ragnaros live for like 5 turns, and then the player loses? You know, it's crazy.
Yeah, that's true. That was quite a game. And Savitz, even though he lost, he has that smile on his face, and he acknowledges it was a very interesting one. And this Mage deck is producing these awesome games. I think the consistency is a little bit low. I think now it's 2 losses and 1 win, I believe. But still, quite an entertaining run. And, well, if Savitz is going to win, he is going to have to come up with a win from that deck somehow.
So we are in the finals now. So unlike earlier, it's a best of five, right? Yep. So the players have to win with all of their decks. Earlier in the tournament, they had the option to maybe just not play it. Maybe if Savitz wasn't comfortable with this mage after that game, he could just play his other two decks. But not anymore. He's got to win with all three of these. And we'll see what order he decides to go with.
I feel like he was comfortable. Like, he opened it with it in his opening games. He opened it with it here in the final. He won with it. He replayed it. The thing was, in the best of three, when you have three decks, if you play a deck and you lose, you can just choose not to play it, which was the way Amaz ended up going with the Druid. So, yeah, we'll have to see what happens here. A lot of decisions left to be made, and lots of big minions left to be played.
But you're not a rapper.
What? So I'm wondering, last game, would he have done better with the Onyxia instead of the Rag?
I think so.
Just pointing 8 plus 5 damage at the face every turn?
It would have messed up his duplicate, so. You're right. But in order for that to mess up duplicate, there would have to have been consecration.
Right?
Yeah.
You wouldn't have True Silver to 1-1.
Maybe to test for it. What else are you going to True Silver face on that board?
Well, that's how we won, yeah.
Oh, that's true.
All right, well, Amaz tries the Druid. The Druid is the deck that Amaz has not produced a win with yet.
See if there is a dragon on time here for Savitz.
I like Naturalize in the general case, just because I feel like you're almost always in a position where you're clogged in your hand a little bit. But sometimes the Dragon Priest really needs that dragon, or that second dragon in some cases, and Naturalize doesn't really work too well with that.
I do think it's a really important tool for Druid against the Priest deck, though. The way that Priest would tend to beat most Druids is by just making a very large minion early.
It's the dream.
Yeah, the dream. The turn two, Coin Velen's Chosen on Twilight Drake. This is exactly what you want as the Priest player. And all of a sudden...
Naturalize.
Yeah, you know, I think it
might... Well, you got two. You might as well.
Maybe. I would. I like this play more, actually, yeah.
You do?
Take your time. You need to cycle. That hand doesn't do anything. You can afford to take some damage for a while.
Okay. Well, there goes Aedas Darkbane. That's the sister that deals 3 damage to a random target when you target it with one of your spells. And Savitz does have one. He has the Power Word Shield left.
All right, so Keeper of the Grove gets picked up. That's an option for this turn. He could silence the Whelp.
I must don't mind silence and innervate Wrath or Pain.
You know, I like the decision to hold off on that innervate, though. Amaz has this kind of hand that's just kind of all removal, reactive cards. You want to save that innervate just to give you more options later on. Play that Ice Howl on turn 7.
Does he get the strike? He does. That allows him to keep his 2-1 Whelp in play. Picks up a Death, a very important card in this matchup, as we've seen so far in the tournament. Priest has been one of the dominant classes, I feel, largely because of that card. Largely because the removal is so efficient at 3 mana.
Yeah, I mean, in the case of Priest, your early game minions are strong because of the dragon synergies with Wormrest Agent and Twilight Whelp. Your removal is good against the expensive minions. You have Vol'jin, Shadow of Death. The whole package just works really well together.
What about this? Illidan Innervate into double Naturalize.
That's
power play, or the ultimate tempo play into a Light Bomb that you'll probably give him from that.
There might not be room for Light Bomb in these decks.
I think we have seen it in some of the Priest decks, though Savitz, I'm not sure.
Yeah, he might have one.
There it is.
There you go. You call it, Crip. I see.
And Lothab does actually lock that out. Limits a lot of Amaz's options. In fact, he's either playing Illidan or Stalag, and it seems silly to play Illidan in this situation.
Absolutely. It's going to force Amaz to play a little bit mana inefficient, but not too big of a deal. Still good stats on that creature. I think he's just going to Shadow or Death here. Keep his guys alive. Oh, okay. I like this. Yeah, Savitz wants to keep the pressure on. He has the board. Amaz is getting pretty low. Stay aggressive.
His guys will not stay alive. His guys are getting naturalized, I believe. And Illidan Storm Rage is going to show us that sometimes this little old guy can pull the win.
Well, easy. Savitz has a smile on his face. He was not prepared. Except, I suppose Light Bomb will do it.
Well, Rend also does it, but... But what do you think is more valuable in this situation?
Amaz is pretty low on cards. I don't expect him to flood the board with too many things, so I would use Light Bomb and then use Rend on, like, one single...
Big guy,
yeah. Something that could win the game on its own, like a Ragnaros, for example.
Mm-hmm. All right, well, Light Bomb does do it. Well, Amaz not too happy with that. He has the Ice Howl, which is not something you play on an empty board. Oh, the Fugin, though, that is a big one.
That's a huge deal. We've already seen Stalag die, and... All of a sudden, Savitz is facing a potential 11-11, but Shadow or Death is just such a clean answer for that.
I really like the Cro-Magnus here. I think Cro-Magnus is so unlikely to die. It'll die, but it's very unlikely to.
Yeah, I like that play. I can see that.
I mean, it's not like Saviz has even seen Ice Howl in the tournament.
That's true.
So Cro-Magnus effect doesn't even work, though, because he'll discard the extra card.
He would. That's true.
He can just play it anyways.
Saviz doesn't want to play Ragnaros because he knows that if he kills that 4-7, it will be replaced with a Thaddeus, and he can't really have an 11-11 up against a Ragnaros when he gets the attack right away. Mm-hmm. So he's going to opt for this play. Still remains mana efficient, the hallmark of an experienced tournament player. And Maz just going to make his Thaddeus, take the trade, and all of a sudden Ice Owl's in play. There's two threats Saviz needs to deal with. Man, that animation
is cool. Really.
Well, the thing with Ice Howl is you can wait a little bit if you need to.
Of course Ice Howl's golden, man. That's... What kind of Ice Howl do you play?
Well, he cannot rend and death. But if you death, what do you play?
Emperor Thorsen for sure.
Yeah, I mean, that's seven cards, and at least five of them are very clunky.
Yeah. Definitely needs this mana reduction right now. So the thing going to Saviz's favor is that, well, Maz is just very low on resources. He needs to peel a big minion right now, or else his turn is just going to be very inefficient.
Yeah, well, it's going to be that second one. It is going to be an inefficient turn.
That's actually a fantastic Mark of the Wild.
You think so?
Well, as strong as Priest is, it doesn't have a hero power like Mage to be able to deal with one health minions, so he has to commit something to dealing with this. I mean, luckily for Saviz, he has a Blackwing Corruptor, which is pretty efficient, but...
Blackwing the 4-3 and play the Geddon. Probably not see play. While it is a big minion, it's not really something you'd want to give your opponent with Mulch. In this case, there are plenty of better big minions to choose from.
Yeah, I mean, that's the beauty of Mulch. It's sometimes just give them a minion that's not worth playing the entire game, and then it becomes a pretty efficient removal spell. Cool thing about the Priest deck, too, is most of the minions don't have anything like Death Rattle, so hard removal, things like Assassinate, Mulch, those kinds of cards, actually much more effective against Priest than most classes.
Oh, Ragnaros here, but if this misses, this might be the end for Maz. It's going to be very difficult to come back.
Oh, no. I've seen a Maz play Ragnaros before.
Ragnaros doesn't miss.
Cro-Magnus is dead. Oh! Well, there's a bug, but luckily we have Blizzard Staff here to address that.
All right, well, I just like playing Ragnaros here. You either kill your opponent or kill his Rag for free. That seems like a good deal to me.
It's not bad. Rend Blackhand is a much, much cooler entrance animation, though, and I feel like the game is unlosable at this point, so.
Throw down some more Mress Agents.
There you go. Board.
Oh, let's see if Saviz's Ragnaros misses.
Are you mocking me?
I think even if it misses, it's pretty hard to lose this. Well, it missed. I guess Amaz needs like another mulch. Yeah, I think Amaz needed a mulch. He'd mulch his own Sylvanas, get Ragnaros, and Ragnaros would kill the 6-8. Which has probably happened a few times in Hearthstone.
Yeah, I believe that. All right, well, Saviz ties it up. Solid draw. We haven't seen the Priest lose yet, I don't think.
Is that right?
I don't think I've seen a lot lose once, yeah.
All right.
One, even when he mind games the Doomsayer.
Oh, that's true. That's true. But that might be a little bit due to the fact that the Mage deck may be a little bit weak in this format. And unfortunately, Safiz still has to win with that. We've also seen Amaz's Druid deck not able to take a game at all. The Druid deck is 0-2. How do you reflect back on your prediction? You thought maybe Druid was the class to pick. Is it really just the Astral Communion? Is that the one missing ingredient?
Well, yeah. I mean, even though the class is the same as an Astral Communion deck, the deck is itself is different by like over 20 cards. So it's unfair to call this like the type of Druid deck we had in mind, but it's also very good. I think that there are a lot of interesting card choices like Mark of the Wild that Amaz has in mind, and we've seen it sort of work out. Like when he plays it on Ice Howl, keeps his minion alive at one health. Plays like that are normally pretty efficient, and I think that the deck isn't bad. It's just that the decks that have been played up to this point are just a little bit better.
What do you think will have the harder time taking a game? Do you think it's going to be maybe the Mage or the Druid hype?
Probably the Mage.
We've probably the Mage.
Back and forth.
All right. Well, we'll have to see. Game three is about to begin.
I just want to see some Ragnaros hero power. You know, we've seen a lot of Fire Lording. We haven't seen the hero power come down, so.
Well, I think Saviz is very confident in Major Domo at the start, and that confidence started dropping off very quickly as the games started rolling out.
I would love to see Amaz keep that mind games.
Okay, well, this is Saviz's Warrior. Warrior was a fairly anticipated class because of the very efficient removal. You know, players have to play 10 World of Warcraft raid bosses. Most of them die to plain removal. But it's just really hard to remove something and actually play something that's very threatening. A warrior can absolutely do that with one mana removals. They can even play a 9-mana Nefarian in some cases.
Absolutely. I mean, it really is just one of the classes that seems like it's just capable of dealing with the late game very effectively. Like you mentioned, tempo is such a big deal in this matchup when both decks have so many late game minions.
Oh boy, double mind games. Let's roll the dice.
That's the dream, right?
Can be.
Well, I don't think there's Doomsayers and Warrior.
Oh,
that's not bad. That'll do. Savitz looks happy.
Turn 3, 8-8.
It's not bad. We've seen a 12-12 and an 0-7, so, you know, we've seen better, but.
Yeah, that's true. Well, I think we're going to slam, and if it's bad, we're going to slam again.
Oh, no, so execute. All right, so Savitz is going to be hurting here, taking some quick damage, and that second mind games is not going to be any prettier. He needs to see something like an Acolyte of Pain off of this, or else he's in for a world of hurt.
Oh, looks really? Like Maz favors the Nat Pagel. He probably thinks that Saviz is holding a weapon here, and he values the heal over a random mind games factor.
Yep, just playing around potential Deathspike. A very likely card for Saviz to have.
Well, it's not like really it's not going to work too well here. Amaz has a ton of counters in his hand, but can you really blame him from playing it? The only other option would be Lotheb and new weapon next turn, I guess.
I'm excited to see some pants on Nat Pagel, to be honest. Do you know the Nat Pagel attack sound when he attacks? It's howdy.
Yeah.
Fun fact.
Okay. Well, that was a fun fact indeed. Yeah. So if he goes with Lotheb, he is going to try to perhaps do the Fiery War Axe play. A Light Bomb and an Illidan. Not often the two cards you end up drawing through Nat Pagel. But this is the game that we're playing. He doesn't have too many plays. It's really the Piloted Treader or the Vol'jin. And the Vol'jin doesn't really see much play. You're basically just playing a card for tempo, and Piloted Treader probably gives you at least as much as that.
Now we're going to see Amaz get in for 8 instead of taking the trade onto Lotheb. Makes some sense. Warrior could likely have a lot of things that deal 1 damage. But what a Sylvanas. Coming out from Savitz, really, really good on a board like this.
Actually, Amaz is 2 damage from lethal here. He's got 12, and he can double Velen's Chosen here.
Yeah.
That's a lot of damage.
Well, if you put Savitz at 2, you can force him to armor or die to Berengeddon.
Mm-hmm.
And he likely can't deal with the board without armor. Yeah.
That is a pretty big gamble, though.
Yeah,
to buff your minions into a Sylvanas.
It's probably not worth the risk. So maybe we'll see a Vol'jin come out. I'm not really sure. Honestly, it's one of those turns where there's a lot of options for Amaz here. He might even see a Mind Games.
Yeah, I feel like Amaz is really contemplating what might be in Saviz's decks. But, I mean, after seeing a Major Domo,
yeah.
The dice has a lot of numbers on it.
Oh, yeah. Well, quickly. All of the plays are a little bit awkward against Sylvanas. There isn't a play that's exceptional against the card, so I might like to see just the most aggressive line of play here.
Mm-hmm.
Play 2 Velen's Chosen, go face. Maybe that's a little ambitious.
Holy cow.
Now he's going to go for it. He's going to choose to put all the buffs on Nefarian. Solid play. He knows that Savice doesn't have Execute yet, or else Nefarian would already be dead. Oh, that is huge.
Yeah, that makes a very good playable card, and it encourages you to armor because you're
that
on 7 mana.
That is the only card Savice could have drawn to flip this board.
Well, he does have two of them, though.
Right, but because of that draw, he's going to be able to flip a board from two life from a game that looked unwinnable, be ahead on board, and not die to Berengen, which is nuts.
Yeah, he's looking for Nefarnax to stay alive so he can take it with a Sylvanas. Oh.
I think this is fine, actually. There are very few spells that deal a little bit of damage, and if it's something like Blackwing Corruptor that kills that, you still steal it.
What about Berengen? You get him to two, and then it actually hits his own face at the end of his turn. So he's forced to armor up.
That's true.
And is that the sister that can snipe with the two damage?
No, nope. That is the sister that gains Divine Shield in a lot of cases.
I see the Shadow or Death on one health minion. Sometimes that's what Priest has to do to deal with Sylvanas.
All right, well, looks like we are in the coin flip mode. Ragnaros is going to fire 8 damage worth of stuff, and if it hits the 5-5, Savitz will continue in this game.
Savitz is incredibly far behind. He needs to hit this shot to stay in the tournament here in the Challenge Stone Finals, and he doesn't do it. That's game. Amaz is going to take the win.
Yeah, but it is best of 5. And so far, actually, both the players who made it here made it on the back of comebacks. Both of them lost their opening games. So we'll have to see. Unfortunately, it's very hard for me to predict who's going to win this one because contrary to the earlier matches, there was no real winner in the trash talk battle.
Yeah, a little bit disappointing, not going to lie. I don't know what to say, man. They need to step up. Really what needs to happen is Froden needs to come in and coach a little bit in that aspect of it.
There is no doubt about that.
All I know is I'm cheering for Savitz because I know Reynad's going to be cheering for Amaz, so I need to balance it out a little bit.
Absolutely.
Yeah, I'm sure that's the case. Well, Savitz still has that mage deck. Amaz still has that druid deck. It feels like this warrior deck is actually pretty good. It feels fairly well balanced. It seems like it could take a game off any deck. Mm-hmm. And in that case, Mind Games just
that's a strong
rolled
card
very well.
In that matchup, too, like against one of the more balanced decks, maybe in like a Priest Mirror, if you Mind Games, maybe you get like a Twilight Whelp or something unimpressive. But against a control deck, all of Savitz's early game is going to be Acolyte of Pain and removal. So you're almost always going to get something really large. So to be able to play Mind Games turn 3 and 4, that's like the dream draw for Amaz.
Yeah, he didn't quite get the Deathwing, but an 8-8 was absolutely enough there. And, well, we'll have to see. We'll have to see. So far, some of the classes not picked in this challenge, I believe we have not seen any Warlock decks and any Hunter decks. Was there any other missed ones, you think?
No, we saw some players build both the Hunter and the Warlock, though. We did see a Mexna, I think it was Froden's Hunter deck, stuck it in there, and then someone was building Warlock, but just deleted it.
Yeah. Well, I think in this challenge, 10 World of Warcraft raid bosses, anything is possible. I was pretty happy to see Froden be adventurous with the classes, but I'm glad that at least Savitz made it, who was mostly adventurous with the cards. Speaking of adventurous cards, that is probably the highest point. Major Domo.
Yeah, if you're looking at Amaz's hand before that naturalized draw, that was quite a good deck.
Yes.
But now it's going to be kind of the battle of a more standard list with naturalizes and mulches. Against Savitz's control hybrid freeze mage thingy.
Whoa. Well, now with Kel'Thuzad, you might save that ramp for Kel'Thuzad instead of Ancient of Lore.
Well, the thing about Kel'Thuzad is, sure, you could play it early on an empty board, but then it's not really getting too much value. Usually you want to play it the turn that you trade stuff in, so I wouldn't mind seeing an Ancient of Lore come before the Kel'Thuzad.
Theronasis does come down. Is it too early for a Doomsayer? Oh, I guess it is. If
you have the back-to-back combo, you can just save it for later. Well, first one gets silenced, you just immediately throw down the second one.
Well, Druid is actually the only class running silence the whole tournament, I believe. So it is a little bit of an inconvenience, but with the way the matches went down, Savitz has to get through this Druid deck somehow with a mage.
Generally, mage decks that rely on Doomsayer and Icebox, such as Giant's Mage or Freeze Mage, are traditionally awful versus Druid. But in this case, when you have like two Freezes and two Doomsayers back-to-back, it's actually pretty good. This is how you win.
Well, Amaz basically played Astral Communion.
Yeah, he did. I mean, that is a lot of ramp. Matsavica is going to help retake that board. That Lothar is going to stop any Innervate or coin shenanigans.
And it's that board is going to stop Kel'Thuzad shenanigans, because I don't believe Amaz is interested in losing all his mana crystals.
Yeah, well, if Amaz... Oh, that's a good point. I mean, even if you Kel'Thuzad your Nanasus Aspirants, you still lose the crystals. You don't get them back.
Well, you can lose a crystal more than once.
Right,
you
yeah.
Get the darn
every single
again.
Turn, yeah.
Well, that's a funny interaction you don't frequently see.
Looks like Savitz has to wait one more turn before he can do two Doomsayer turns in a row into Major Domo, into Alex.
Yeah, because he can expect the first one to get silenced by a Keeper of the Grove, pretty common card in Druid decks. And the second time he does the Doomsayer freeze combo is going to cost him 8 mana. So
we do see another form of removal, though, and Naturalize that might get thrown down.
Mm-hmm. Actually, you mentioned a very interesting thing. I had almost forgotten this fact, but when you are a Ragnaros character after Major Domo's Death Rattle triggers, you can set your HP higher than 8 by Alistraz and yourself to 15. That's what you were citing, right? Wow. I don't believe I've ever seen that.
It was like when the Major Domo first came out, people were like thinking, it was like a question that people like tweeted.
Mm-hmm. Well, it looks like Amaz has a lot of answers here. He does seem to be a bit favored, but Amaz does have to face the second Doomsayer. It just might be a little bit too late here.
Absolutely. So, let's see if the early Doomsayer is going to hurt at all. I think he's just gonna do what you guys mentioned, run the Blizzard out. Second Blizzard next turn with the Doomsayer. Lothar's getting in for a good chunk of damage. And I mean, as non-aggressive as this mage deck is, it's still very relevant. Getting your opponent low enough makes cards like Ragnaros a real threat really quickly.
Amaz here can play Nefarin with Naturalize, and that again is a very, very efficient way to remove cards. He doesn't get quite the mage cards he's gotten in the past with those Fireball finishers, Pyroblast, none of that. It's gonna be Mirror Image and a Flame Cannon.
Absolutely. All right, so Mirror Image. Honestly, not too bad of a card in this format. Mm-hmm. Sometimes you just have a lot of big minions. If that stops two attacks from an 8-8, that's very, very good value for a one-mana card.
Well, Saviz is going to do a Doomsayer play here, but we know that it's going to be a bit challenging because of the Naturalize.
This is actually the second time we've seen this mage deck kind of get a board lead and then use freeze effects for tempo while just getting in a lot of free damage. So even though the deck is just so defensive, Lothep's dealing 15 damage this game. I mean, that is pretty substantial.
Wow, Defender of Argus makes use of the silenced Doomsayer.
Yeah, not bad.
He could even play a duplicate with it and just taunt up only the Doomsayer.
That would be a pretty cool play. I think we might see that. It's pretty mana efficient.
Without any freezes, I'm pretty sure Maz is just going to be able to go right past it or just kill it.
All right, interesting. So he chooses not to taunt up the Lothab, even with the... Oh, he's just going to choose not to play duplicate. Again, that makes a lot of sense.
Yeah, 5-1 just trades too favorably against Lothab to really warrant keeping up. Yeah. Well, Amaz has the KT still, and it's starting to get like a much better turn to play it.
Yeah, Amaz is definitely considering the Kel'Thuzad play this turn. I think he's going to go for it because he has two pretty solid ways to trade his minions off.
I have to find out he has 15 potential mana to use.
That is quite a bit.
But yeah, I mean, very likely to see something like Wrath KT here. Really just a lot of options when you have that much mana, that many cards in hand.
Well, that suggests KT probably won't be played, because if you play KT, you actually want to kill off as many minions as possible.
Maybe changed his mind. All right.
No, this is consistent.
Yeah. Solid play. Innervate the Mark to play around Savitz's hero power, killing off his minion. And yeah, board looks pretty strong for Maz at this point. He recognizes that all of his minions survive Flame Strike unless they're hero powered, so at least two of them will live if Saviz has that card.
Well, Nefarian's a pretty good pickup here for Saviz, but is it good enough?
Yeah, I mean, we've seen Nefarian doing crazy stuff in this game so far in this entire tournament. If Nefarian picks up something like Poison Seeds, for example, mm-hmm. that could be pretty strong.
Now, often in this similar type of deck that people have tried to get working on constructed, the Emperor duplicate synergy is extremely strong, but I feel in this case you're just too far behind. You're playing too slow of a deck to really make use of it.
Yeah, it really has to come down on 6 so you can play it again on 7, 8, and then get your whole hand cheap before you die to Force Combo, for example.
Savagery!
Does 0 damage.
Yeah. Well, if you get Spell Power, that can deal some.
Time runs out on me.
Well,
not a great card, though.
Amaz could mulch his minion into a Savage Combatant.
Okay.
But the chance of that is basically zero. All right, Amaz gets the Stalag. Stalag is a very fun little guy when it comes to naturalizing your own Stalag with KT up. But I don't think you really need to get that fancy this game. Looks like it's just going to be a straight up KT play here.
Amaz taking it slow. I mean, he recognizes that there's so much AoE that can be in this mage deck. No. All right, he's going to drop the KT.
Yeah, with Doomsayer's gone, and Amaz even has a tempo naturalize. And naturalize is a really, really powerful card at this stage in the game.
So I don't think we've seen any Kaldara Drakes, any Garrison Commanders, none of the usual combos we see with Major Domo on Constructed. I say usual combos like the deck is common, but the few people who do play usually incorporate those combos. Mm-hmm. Anyway, without that, if Saviz manages to survive as the Ragnaros hero, at this point, is he too far behind to really use that to catch up?
Yeah, I believe he is. I mean, Amaz is at 18 HP, and he can even bump that up another one. I just don't see how Saviz ends up winning this.
Definitely tough.
I mean, this is the best play, but it's still very far from putting Saviz in a winning situation. I know there's some strange interaction between Major Domo and Ice Block. I believe if your hero goes immune and then you become a different hero, you no longer have immunity. Do you know anything about that, Hype? I know you're the resident mage expert.
I am the mage expert, but I have not played much Major Domo mage.
Okay. Well, maybe after watching this, you'd never play Major Domo mage.
But I will be playing the Stalag and Pugin combo because it seems pretty strong.
It does actually seem pretty strong.
I think Savitsa's best bet right now is to somehow sneak 15 on the board and then go with a Frost Nova and then go for the Alex kill. Which, without a second Ice Block, I don't think it's happening.
I think there's some chance there is a second Ice Block in his deck, but how can he play enough stuff with a 3-mana Ice Block at this point?
No, is this it? Did Amaz just win BlizzCon?
Challenge run, yes. Oh, Savagery Synergy, Divine Shield, 0 damage, doesn't break a Divine Shield, I think.
There we go.
It does not.
We found a use script. The dream.
All right, well, unfortunately for Saviz, it looks like Amaz is going to take the match here with the final little bit of damage required with the Keeper. Keeper Silence on the Ragnaros guarantees the hit. Well played by Amaz, well built decks. And we have our BlizzCon Challenge Stone champion, Amaz. What's your take on this, Rayned?
That was a sweet tournament. A lot of really unique interactions. We saw a lot of cool cards that we don't usually get to see played. Mind Games had some cool storylines in the tournament. I mean, yeah, it was a cool thing to have here at BlizzCon. It's an awesome event. I'm glad that we could bring such a cool format to the World Championship. And you know, hopefully we can
Absolutely.
Do it again next year.
Absolutely. Yeah, Mind Games was a really big card. I think Frodan ran one copy, and Amaz ran two copies. And even though Priest, I believe, lost 0 games, that was probably the most spectacular way you could win the games. So, at least a very good show.
Absolutely.
All right. Well, I think Amaz is down on stage with Rachel. Let's get a feel on how he feels after winning that.
Yep, I'm down here with our winner, Amaz, and you've got to be pretty happy about that, right?
Yeah, I'm pretty proud of myself.
So talk to me a little bit about the deck building process, because Challenge Stone is all about creativity, all about new rules, building a deck, and that's something that pro players like you have to do a lot, whether it's a new expansion like League of Explorers, or it's something like Challenge Stone. So give me some insight into the process.
Well, the format is you bring a lot of big creatures and you can't bring a big game hunter, right? So naturally, you want some other answers. So I put in like naturalized, mulch, you know, cards that you don't normally see. And because we did have to put the sisters in, the three drops, I just went with the three classes that can have buffs. So Priest has Power Shield, Paladins have a lot of buffs, Druid has Mark of the Wild. So that's naturally my three classes that I went for.
And how does that compare to deck building for ladder, deck building for tournaments?
Well, it's obviously very different, but I guess it's quite similar to when, for example, a new set comes out, right? Everybody doesn't know the best cards or what the meta is going to be. So it's kind of like that. It's kind of like a new set. So I really like Challenge Stone. And since I won this one, I'm sure Crip will invite me to the next one, right?
We shall see. Savitz, you're also a player that builds a lot of his own decks. Do you agree with Amaz's answer, or what is your process when it comes to a brand new expansion like League of Explorers or something crazy like Challenge Stone?
Well, I'm a bit devastated by my last loss. I'm still losing, I don't know. But I have so many regrets about the Major Dome right now. Why did I play that card? Turns out it's not that good.
So mistakes can be made in the deck building process, but you will rise above. I believe in you.
I actually have some questions for you as well. So, Amaz, you are the only player who were running Ice Hole in the deck. Do you think the card is special? Did it help you win the whole series?
Well, I mean, we did need 10 bosses, right? And I guess Ice Hole was a good choice in Druid because you can silence it and it could go face. But otherwise, it does a charge, so it's kind of like a legendary that does something, right? You always want minions that do something the turn you play them. So Ice Hole fills in that niche. So, and it's very cool to play him, so yeah.
Yeah, it was absolutely pretty cool to see Ice Hole. The other question would be Warlock. Nobody played Warlock. So it's a question to both of you guys. Like, why Warlock was bad in this format?
Well, I think that the reason why Warlock was bad is because of the expensive removal. Because there's no big game hunter and you have to play Siphon Soul and that's 6 mana. With so many legendary cards, you just cannot remove all that stuff. That's why I personally, for example, went for Warrior for those cheap executes instead of those 6 mana Siphon Souls.
I actually thought of playing Warlock as my third deck because Sacrificial Pact kills Illidan. So, and then I was like, nah, that's too gimmicky, so yeah. But what's if you said?
Well, final question for you, Amaz. You are the winner of our Challenge Stone tournament here at BlizzCon. That means that you are taking home a signed and framed poster autographed by the entire Hearthstone dev team. So how do you feel about your prize and about winning a tournament on the same stage that your teammate won last year, the Hearthstone World Championship stage?
Yeah, I guess it's good to continue the trend that Archon players are pretty good at the game. And I'll go home and frame this, and looking forward to next year.
All right.
Well, next year's Challenge Stone, that is.
Next year's Challenge Stone, indeed. Not next year's Hearthstone World Championship?
Yeah, but it didn't finish yet, so I shouldn't jump the gun.
All right. Well, that concludes our first day's broadcast. Congratulations once again to our Challenge Stone winner, Amaz, and to our 4 players who are continuing on tomorrow. Don't forget to tune in tomorrow morning at 11 a.m. Pacific to catch the final 3 matches of the 2015 Hearthstone World Championship. I'm your host, Seltzer. We've loved having you today, and we can't wait to see you again tomorrow.
the 2015